Okay, I am Demi Gechko, and since 96, 97, the academic community in Brazil began a chapter, a local chapter, an ISOC chapter, and we 3 years ago began to try to rejuvenate that chapter, and now it's running. It's about 200 members in Brazil. I am a vice president of this Brazilian chapter, and this is the way I have some relationship with ISOC. We have a very old relationship with IANA functions since the times of John Postel and so. And it's important to clean these functions and to have a better understanding how the oversight will be done. I think the oversight has to be done by the community in some way. And we are very happy that NTIA is proposed to end the actual contract in the next year, September. My personal objective, I think we'll try also to very hard to hear from the community, is to keep the things simple. I suppose it's a very clear transition. We have to keep it contained in some way in the essence of this transition, but we have to be open to hear what the people wants to say on that, but asking a very straight question. How we can do this transition without harming the internet itself. The concerns are that obviously there are a lot of things discussed in IGF and ICANN meetings and so. And maybe anyone interested in these questions try to use every opportunity to discuss and put forward their own objectives and agenda. And my concern is to keep this special issue in a very focused way. Yeah, we are doing some bureaucratic work right now, but I suppose we are quite at the end of the RFP, and we will be open to consultation in the community. It's a very large consultation, and we hope that we will have some kind of answers to begin to work on the proposal in the very beginning of the next year. Maybe at the end of January, we'll have some solid or some substantive proposals to show to NTIA and try to go forward. I think that the point here is how to educate people towards this particular issue, because it's quite a technical issue. Of course, there are a lot of political issues in ICANN, in IGF, in all the internet issue, but this, I think, has to be kept far from politics and much more focused to the technical aspects. Then it's very, very important to have a way to educate people and to explain the historical reasons why the things are the way they are. It's a very interesting group because there are people from every part of the world and every kind of community. But it's very tough people and it's very good to be with them and I'm very proud to be part of this group.